Hello! I hope you can see me or something. He's a bit of a noodly one. I started this little... riff, and he's like, oh, this is a good thing. Let's do a thing with this. And I'm using this today. This is my new toy. It's the, what is it? Oh yes, it's the Ableton Push. And
yeah,
it's a nice thing.
It's meant that you work with Ableton, obviously, which is if you're down with the musics.
It's a door, and it's made for this specific door, but I'm using it with reason, because, you know, sticking it to the man. Take that, man. I can show my face as well, because that's the kind of fly guy I am. Here we go. Whoa. Isn't this all very technical? It's very fancy. So here we are, reason on the screen, and yeah, this way. Reason. So let's get things started, shall we? I think we need a beat. I've got this nice thing.
All it does is make drums. All it does is make bass drums.
Weird. There's been a reason often does this actually,
where it misses out the first note you play.
Let's get rid of that for now. I have an idea that could work.
I am not going to dingle anyone's pooper, by the way. I can see your comments, you rudies.
A 4 to the floor beat. But things are gonna get interesting now, because I'm gonna start adding Kongs and stuff. Oh gosh, many windows open at once.
Quite fancy.
A lot of people didn't think it was worth the sort of upgrade, but I like it. It's pretty lush. Making music is not a quick process. Sorry.
you need to play all the keys. Yes, I did. Meet Brian May. He's a lovely fella. He's very relaxed. I guess you would be if you're Brian May. What you got to worry about? Apart from badges. And that's it, really. But yes, he's a very nice man. Very nice indeed. And the coolest thing was they got out the master tapes for Flash Gordon. And I was just playing with the original soundtrack of Flash Gordon. Just like, wow. Very cool. wanted to use has run out. I really should have bought it. Slightly annoying. What's this? Rob Crosh is asking, what reverb was this? We've got two different reverbs here. We've got, let's see, a Rob Prapen, or Papen, reverb. We've also got a few echoes. We've got Echo Bode, which is a very nice echo unit. You can do some crazy stuff with that. And the very deep, long, lush one is Deep Reverb. Obviously, good name for it, because that's exactly what it is. Very deep.
Very reverb.
Nice. But this just helps get me back to here. Here we are in the note editor. triplets. I knew it. Sorry, can you not hear me on the microphone? I can turn myself up. Here we go. Let's do this. Are we? Where am I? Microphone checker. Oh. You could do Bunsen and Beaker. Anyway, less of that, more of this. Sound the other day, it's quite nice. I didn't even fit with this. Let's give it a go anyway. We also need something about this beat. It's not valid for now, is it? Oh, try. I don't know if you can hear that wonderful sound in the background. We've got plumbers in. They're very nice. They're giving us a nice bath because at the moment our bath's poo. You can get in and it covers your knees, and if you try and fill it in fuller, then, you know, it just goes out the overflow a bit. It's rubbish. Why would you ever fit a bath that rubbish? I don't know. Oh, I've got a drink. Delightful. No advertising here. Here we go. Oh, I just stubbed it. Let's stop this and take a little moment. I'm a bit thirsty. Hello. That's a bit weird. Have you seen this? Well, I'm taking a beverage break. Look at that. Final baby. Look at the other side. So good. So good. Limited edition. It's rather lush. Oh, it's nice to have a drink. Right, let's get this beat under control. Yes. Right. We need another. We'll call this drums. Drum master. Have you heard of parallel compression? Parallel compression's brilliant. You see, that's way too loud. But here we go. So the thing with parallel compression is, I'm gonna get really nerdy and boring. Enjoy, everyone. Oh, that's just louder. Yes, it is. It's rubbish, isn't it? Go on that. Why have all these come in? Oh, of course. It's stuff. Right. So what we do? Oh, can I get this full screen? Yes. Brilliant. Here we go. Compress that. Oh, that sounds terrible, you say. You're right, it does. This is what we're doing. We make it sound really quite terrible. God, I'm mixing on headphones. This is not fun. Oh, that's god awful. But wait. Wait and see. So here we go. Another game. It's exactly the same. It's a parallel channel. Of course it's the same. Compress that. Not really what we want to be yet, though. So what do? We bring up a nice... You can't see any of this, what I'm doing. There we go. It's better, isn't it? Here we go. Right. We've got an EQ thing. You can't see that either, but it doesn't matter. You just have to trust me, I'm doing stuff now. Right. So on this... We just want to find the bass. God. That's a lot of bass. We can probably gate that a bit. And then we do the same again. Why do we do the same again? Well, not exactly the same. Obviously, that would be stupid. What we do is we max out the thing so it's all clippity-cloppity, ebbity-bobbity. But it brings out the mids and the clickiness, which is nice. Which, after all, everything you've done, it salvages everything. And then, we just... This is it without parallel compression, and this is it with. So we've got a bit more control over our lovely sound. It's fatter. So fat. But now we have to rein this in. This is what we're gonna do. This will be our master. Master. I am the drum master. Make sure it doesn't go too loud now. We know our drum's behaving, so what isn't behaving? That is not what you want. Parallel compression, very cool. What have we muted here? Going. Who are we really? Let's get this over here. Right, but it's automatically better because that arpeggio is not playing. Lose that. That's quite nice. So what have we learned? We've learned we don't want that there. We've got no melody. We've got no hook. We've got no... need a buffer on the main thing.
Yeah.
That's what we're gonna do. Drum master.
Drum master or drums?
Drums.
Drums.
Yes.
On this, there's a way of making it go backwards.
Loop on.
Here we go. Look.
Gonna do a tape stop. We like those. There's a new fancy thing at the moment, isn't it? All the hip young kids are doing tape stops. Hey, I'm not a hip young kid. I wear a hat because I am not a hip young kid. But never mind. Here we go. What am I doing? Tape stop. Yes.
Excuse me, pardon me. What am I doing? I know what I'm doing. I'm bouncing mixer channels, of course. I'm sure in other programs there's fancier ways of doing tape stops, but this is, you know, this is perfectly acceptable. This is the way you should do it, probably. Probably. Anyway, new tracks and songs. Got confused. So, what have we got? That's exactly what's playing, though there is an issue because I left this on. And that's not what you want. So we need to do that all over again. Simon, that mastering thing introduces latency, and latency is the death of music. I'll do the same thing I did before, only better. So, that's exciting. My life. Right, what am I doing? I am making a sampler. I am going to side, right, bounce this tool. New samples. Here it is. I drag it onto here. I have a sample I can play. Let's play it. Sounds so good. I could go lower. That's not pointless. What are you? French house. What am I doing? Oh yes, I did the thing that I wanted to do. Right, brilliant. Let's do that then. Here we are. C3. Yes, please.
This should last. Am I still being heard?
Hello?
Yes, apparently yes. Fantastic. That's what we like to hear. Things are working. So we've put that in, we should hear that. Yeah, yeah. Theory that you should filter as well. Why not? Why not? Why the hell not? Bust it. Now let's hear that. Oh, you can't because I'm an idiot. What I want to do is right. Yes. The automation for that. Quarter. In theory, I'm there. What happens? Let's take all these stupid. Oh, it's a bit quiet now, isn't it? Get rid of that. And that's a good point where we can then... Oh, yes, these wonderful boxes behind me. As you may or may not know, we just moved in. Like 9 weeks ago. That's not just moving, you say. You're right, it's not. But these things take time. And where else to put all my stuff? Because I have no studio built yet. So this is going to be my wife's room for wifing around in. And being all like business. She does business. She's good at the business. I'm terrible at business. But yeah, when I my we're getting someone to make a roof attic-y, office-y thing for me. And it's all going to be soundproof. It's going to be lovely. First time for a proper soundproof. It's going to sound amazing. But there is, they're all full of like wires and that. I have a lot of wires. What am I doing? I've lost the plot. I'm used to using this on three screens, so it's become quite confusing seeing it on just one. I think when we hear, that's when we hit it hard, I guess. So we need to decide what bits to keep and which bits to go. Maybe this is a kick drum. I don't even pick up on that. We'll stay in the same key. We'll keep it low. But we're going to do something new because we dropped this. We go. What are we going to do? It's a good question, isn't it? What have I just turned off? Not the thing I wanted to turn on. We need some big beats. Big beats. It's so annoying having one screen. What am I doing? I keep asking that a lot now. My brain's a bit fried right now. It shouldn't be. It's because I'm talking rather than doing, I guess. I'm not much of a talker. He said talking. Kong! Of course. Kong is the best drum module ever. I don't care what you say. You smell. Everyone knows it. Ask your mum. Here we go. I bought this thing. EDM. Is there anything wrong with EDM? I don't know. It's no drum and bass, but it's all right, isn't it? I quite like it. Let's hear our new huge snares and kick lines. Why is it called kick lines? Or like tosh lines. From the bill. That's because I old reference for dad's jokes. I just clicked the entirely wrong thing. You're an idiot. Here we go. Kicks and huge snares. Is this really what passes for a kick drum these days? I don't mind it. It's in the wrong key. Alright, I can get behind it. What are we going to stick here? Well, obviously... Why not? Say that day. I know it has gone a bit big room, hasn't it? You know what? Who wants to hear a Savlotti thing that's in progress? You mustn't tell anyone. You mustn't tell anyone. It's got no lyrics. But it's, I like it. Hello. Might need to turn this one up again. Do 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 do.
Here we go.
This one is on freeze screen, so I can see lots of stuff. Oh, I wonder what's going to happen to you. Which one? I bet that's really confused with wire casting. Oh, well, as long as it plays, who cares? Right. This is where the lyrics will go, obviously. I imagine there'll be lyrics all over the shop. Probably best you can't see this because it's got the name of the album title in, so yeah. What will it be about? It will be... I don't know. I've got this far and I've not really started thinking lyrics. I'm just trying to make an album that's actually sort of... Whoa! That's no good. It's sort of a big homogenous album rather than 8 years of album. It's all going to come together and be nice. Yeah, it's going to be good. On this one, the bass is... Oh! It's an emulator of a Commodore 64. Which sounds like this. I'm sure there's a lot of crackling. I'm hearing a lot of crackling, which must be annoying for you. Sorry about that. Not much I can do. It's not my DSPs. They're fine. Anyway. This is the lyrics I've got at the moment. You and me and bum bum da 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 da. I won't be a lion bum da. Placeholder, I believe, is the name. If you could hear me another sub-lovely one, because I got a bit bored of that tune I was making there. It's not one of my favourite things. Sometimes tunes work, sometimes they don't. We things do not get precious, isn't it? Yes. Don't get precious. Which one? Ooh. This is a weird one, really. It's is it opening? I don't even know. Hello. Sorry, me again. Every time I open, because everything's going through reason. I have to open and make a new channel. Anyway, what's this one? Bit moodier than you used to, if you like something. I know. I've got it down as a... Definitely. But I didn't. you never know. Again, you can't be scared to throw it away, I guess. That's not actually a guitar either. This is the crazy sound, which is... What we got? There's lots of me doing voicey things to make the noise, yeah. There it is. Well, that would be it. Bit Depeche Mode. So that's that one. One more. I don't want to give the whole thing away. Ooh. This next one. My voice will cut off in a second, I'm sure. This is a weird one because it's just been around for ages, but I really, really like the hook on this. Oh wait, this one's filthy. Or is it? No, this one's fine. I'm thinking of a different one. Lyrics still. I could live with this as a chorus on this one. Lovely. Exciting. Anyway, where did we get to? I think we can safely say that this is going nowhere. Oh, but I really wanted to do a full proper tune. I feel like I've let everyone down. I suck. Butts. Sweaty butts. Never mind, you can't win them all, can you? I'm going to finish up. How long have I been doing this? An hour and a bit, goodness. And no real conclusion. What have we learnt today? Some you win, some you lose. Beards are quite noisy. Cats can fit behind radiators and then not get out. That's just stupid cats for you, stupid cats. Yeah. Oh, and the Ableton push is super awesome. Yes, it's crazy awesome. I like it. But we're done now. So, thank you for joining me, all 40 of you. How exciting, 40, wow. I will let you listen to one more track. What have I got work in progress? All right, I've got an upcoming sketch. Is it the sketch? It's difficult to describe, really. With the lovely Oliver, age 24, he's helping me out. But he's going to have some live action probably as well. I might need an actor. I don't know. Anyway, this is... Oh, and the nativity stuff's all coming up as well. Goodness me. Nativity? Advent calendar. What am I thinking? Not doing nativity. Might do a nativity thing in the advent calendar, but... I'm going completely off track, aren't I? Yes. Right, where are we? Oh god, don't look at the screen now. Right. What was it called? It was called... You know when you've got thousands of songs that you never finish, and then you totally finish and forget where the stuff is that you were sending to someone? This is exactly what's just happened to me. Brilliant. Good work, me. Rescue whale, rabbit, parsley boobs. For the life of me, I cannot think what it's called or anything. Brilliant. Good work. Such good work. Maybe it's in a crazy folder. Oh. Ah. Okay, I'm going to play a song from this. This is going to be the thing. The thing. Here we go. I'm gonna try how this sounds. I don't know if I've mixed it yet.
Oh, my sweet little honey, let's get down to Argos, save some money. Prices are low there all year round, thanks to their unusual catalogue system. Argos!
There we go. That's what the next thing's gonna be. There's a few, well, that's part of it. I've not given the whole thing away. Obviously, because why would you do that? That's stupid. Don't be doing that. Honestly, don't do that. Anyway, yes. So we've done that. We've done all the things. I made that sound. I'm very pleased with the sound. The sound itself, it's crazy. Lots of fun. Here we go. Which one is it? This one. So, this is what makes up the sound. I should hide my face for this. My stupid, stupid face. This is really not interesting unless you're into this sort of thing. So, combinators, this is how reason works. You stick a load of things inside one thing, then you can control all of the things with one thing. So we've got one synth doing something simple, and that's got a bit of a crazy reverb on, and it's got some EQ to bring out all the sort of... Then there's the this is a drum module, but what it's doing is ducking the sound when the yellow bits hit. Parallel compression sort of thing. Well, is it parallel compression? Side chaining. Stupid me. Then there's another mixer that everything goes into. Then there's another synth, and that goes into a vocoder, but the vocoder is made into an EQ. Because vocoder EQs do crazy weird things and sound awesome. The saturation, then another synthesizer. And these all go into the thing, come together, and this is one note. Pretty cool, I like it. Let's see if we can... Anyway, you get the idea. It's nice, big. Oh, hello. Why did that? What's this for? Some crazy things in there that shouldn't really be there. Never mind. It'll all work out in the end. What am I looking at? Is this what we were working on? Must be. Anyway, I've said I was going to go. I'm going to go. Goodbye, goodbye. Goodbye to you all. Take care. Be careful on the roads because it's getting dark out. Never sassy mum, and always remember. All right, goodbye to you, tutty bye. I'm off. I'm going to end the stream. Don't try to stop me. I'm going. I'm gone. I'm not gone. How do I go?